and welcome to the 10th video of the IIM Calcutta Insight video series. And today we would be discussing about the impact of monetary policy on the performance of the stock market. We have with us Professor Partha Ray, who has been the Director of the Economics and Policy Research of the RBI and Advisor to the Executive Director of the IMF. So sir, thank you very much for being here. And I'll start with the first question as to how does and to what extent does the monetary policy affect the performance of the stock market?
Interesting question. The answer varies according to the countries. Mm-hmm. So let me first tell you in general terms and then maybe come back to Indian specifics. In general terms, look, end of the day, monetary policy, what it does, it reduces or increases the cost of borrowing. Okay. Suppose you borrow and invest in stock market, then an expansionary monetary policy should give a fillip to the stock market. And a contractionary monetary policy, which should be, you know, constricting the stock market. Now, this is a very simple thing that happens to you. Depending on the cost of borrowing, you would want to create more wealth and therefore might be interested to have more equity in your portfolio. Mm-hmm. But equity is not only thing in your portfolio. Your portfolio may have bonds, you may have company deposits, you may have fixed deposit of a bank, you may have equity as well. Yeah. So, essential question would be, how much monetary policy will affect across the board the holding pattern of this particular securities? Mm-hmm. Now, coming to Indian specific is slightly more interesting. First of all, in Indian case, the extent of banks' exposure to the stock market, which in basically in non-technical term, it means that you can borrow money from the bank and invest in the stock market, that happens very, very low. Okay. There are exposure norms on the banks, so therefore one cannot borrow from the bank and thereby invest in the stock market or any other financial markets. Therefore, you'd expect this phenomenon per se to be happening less in case of India, as far as Indian monetary policy is concerned.
So, but a basic question arises that what kind of industry is mostly affected by the monetary policy changes, and which one of them, what kind of stocks are kind of unaffected by the policy announcements?
Interesting question. It depends on, look, monetary policy does not affect you and me directly. Okay. None of us have any deposit, any account with the Reserve Bank of India. Yeah. We have with a commercial bank. Mm-hmm. So what the RBI does, RBI tries to influence a commercial bank behavior so that they in turn can influence your behavior. Your means you as a household, you as in firm. Mm-hmm. Now, interestingly, what would happen in this case? Obviously, the sectors which are dependent on bank borrowing are likely to be more influenced. For example, you would expect bank stocks to be affected. You expect housing stocks to be affected. You expect the automobile stocks to be affected. Mm-hmm. But you would not expect the IT stocks to be affected that much. Right. So it depends on the extent of dependence of bank borrowing of a particular sector that in this case would influence how much of equity of that sector would be affected in the stock market.
Okay. And in the recent past, we have seen that there have been a lot of non-scheduled policy announcement as well. See, RBI and the Fed announces policy according to a schedule, but the non-scheduled policy announcement affects the stock market in a bigger sense because the investors do not expect such kind of changes in the just the next day. So in that sense, is there a higher correlation between non-scheduled policy announcement with respect to the performance of the stock?
Indeed, and that's a very interesting question. Let me explain why. Now, there's a group of economists called rational expectationists. Mm-hmm. What they thought, and they logically thought the right way, look, end of the day, your information contained and the RBI governor's information content are similar. So something that you anticipate, you already take into account that in your formulation of your budget, mm-hmm. formulation of economic decision. In case of a non-scheduled announcement, this is a shock to you. So that is obviously going to influence your decision much more than a scheduled announcement. In fact, there is a standard proposition in that particular branch of macroeconomics which said that only the unanticipated money would matter, The anticipated money don't matter at all.
And the final question being that since there are a lot of foreign portfolio investors in the market as well, and as well as the Indian investors in the form of mutual funds and other portfolios, so with respect to the announcement made by the RBI and the Fed, if we ask what the major important question as to which one of them matters the most, so what would be an answer to that?
Thus, you know, to caricature your question, what you want to know between Miss Janet Yellen and Dr. Patel, who matters more to the Indian stock market? Let me offer an answer to you. In terms of big investors, there are two groups of people, two groups of investors that matter in the stock market in India. One is your foreign institutional investors, the other is mutual funds. Now, in case of foreign institutional investor, the way they influence the stock market, they will obviously go by the stance of monetary policy in the United States. Because end of the day, it's the typical hedge fund manager, typical private equity fund manager, will think of India as a particular destination. When they think India as a particular destination, what they will do, they will look at the interest differential or return differential between United States and India. And therefore, the moment United States federal fund rate goes up, then the differential between India and the United States goes up as well, and accordingly there might be outflow of capital from India, and that might affect the stock market adversely.
So sir, thank you very much for this insightful video.
It's a pleasure.
And we'll be back with the next episode of the Insight series, and until then, thank you very much for watching.